saw you light on, honey, in the cold. I stood anywhere I go, there you are. You're miles away, but I still feel you. Anywhere I go, there you are. Anywhere I go, there you are. And late at night, when you can't fall asleep, I'll be lying right beside you, counting sheep. Anywhere I go, there you are. Duggies. Thank you guys so much. It's a pleasure to be here with you tonight on this amazing moment. This is a tune called Mess Is Mine. I'm gonna change my guitar.
Got very excited here.
That's better.
Hold on, my darling. Thank you very much. Thank you guys so much. For this next song, this is a kind of slower song, and I just noticed that the sun has gone down and it's dark enough to try this. If you guys have a light on your phone you want to hold up in the air for some mood lighting, please do that. I think it'll look really pretty. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. This is a song called Georgia.
Thank you guys.
life in the middle now. Whoa, my life is so hard. Where's my photo opportunity? I want a shot of redemption. Don't end up a cartoon in a cartoon graveyard. A bone digger, bone digger. Dogs in the moonlight. Far away from my well-lit door. Mr. Beer belly, get these months away from me, you know. I don't find this stuff amusing anymore. Well, if you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal. I can call you Betty, Betty when you call me, you can call me out. Man walks down the street, he says, why am I short of attention now? Short little span of attention now. All my nights are so long. Where's my wife and family? What if I die here? Who'll be my role model now that my role model is gone? Gone. He ducked back down the alleyway with some roly-poly little bad-faced girl. All along, long, there were incidents and accidents. There were hints and allegations. Well, if you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long-lost pal. I can call you Betty, Betty when you call me, you can call me out. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. If you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal. Betty, when you call me, you can call me, yeah. If you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long-lost pal. I can call you Betty. Betty, when you call me, you can call me, yeah.
Thank you so much.
That last song, thank you guys so much. It's been a pleasure to be part of this day. What an amazing game it was. This is a song called Riptide. If you guys know the words, please sing along. Hope you have a fun night. she is destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Yeah, I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Thank you guys so much. Have a great night. Living End coming up.
Vance Joy in the Virgin Australia Premiership Party, and there's still a lot more to cover. What about this?
This is the shenanigans, and look at them. The smiles and the faces in the rooms. Bevo obviously addressing them, but trying to calm them down a little bit. It's hard to keep a lid on now.
We'll speak to one of the heroes in just a moment, Sam Lane in there with Tom Liberatore, and we'll hear from proud dad Tony as well. Congratulations to the Bulldogs. We'll see them out on the ground very soon, and the Living End as well, when the Virgin Australia Premiership Party returns.
What a win! Winks has bolted in the Cox Plate Prince of Penn Dance's history in Flemington for Michelle Hayne.
Remarkable. What an incredible chapter has been written here.
They are away and racing to win one of the world's most famous ocean races.
It's Kerber. He's won a win.
Doesn't. Remains perfect in Melbourne. And what a race it really was.
That is an impressive performance.
Serena's the champion once more.
He's there. Wimbledon champion again.
It's going all the way. That is explosive. Can you believe it? They have won the gold medal.
Usain's going to do it. He's a genius. The greatest.
Ten, it's the 2016 Game Day finale. Lee Matthews, Jude Bolton, and Andrew Welsh deliver their grand final post-mortem. We hear from the victors, plus Simon Marshall and Danny McGinlay give their unique take on the season. And straight after game day, it's all eyes on Flemington as the spring racing carnival kicks up a gear for the time-honoured Turnbull Stakes. It's a huge day of sport right here on 7.
The Bulldogs are premiers, their second premiership, first of them in 1954, and now in 2016, the 62-year drought gets broken. Fantastic scenes, the Liberatores together, and we'll hear from them in just a moment. I'm with Jude Bolton. The Virgin Australia Premiership Party continues soon with the Living End, and we'll see the Bulldogs out on stage introduced to their fans. It's just the best time now for them, isn't it?
Oh, this is when you get caught up as a player and as a supporter and those things. There's so many people out here in blue, red and white out on the MCG, and then when they see their champions walk onto stage, the roar will be enormous.
Who are your heroes today? Jason Johannesson, obviously 33 disposals, superb. Maybe the goal probably
that's what
swayed the Norm Smith.
That's what sealed the Norm Smith. His run was unbelievable. He had 800 metres gained. Tom Boyd was fantastic. Yeah. Obviously Josh Kennedy for the Swans was terrific. 34 disposals, 3 goals, but they were the 3 for mine. Tom Boyd's effort. This is a coming of age of a young man. He stood up. The Swans actually took more marks inside forward 50, but his contest, particularly in the ruck and forward, was just enormous all day.
Hasn't he turned his career around in this month of finals? It's the big time to play big footy, isn't it? Well, we saw the Liberatore's embracing just a moment. We can go inside to the Bulldogs' rooms now. Sam Lane is with the Liberatore's.
Tony and Tom Liberatore, I think you just need to, on behalf of Australia, sip a beer and tell us how this tastes.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
It's surreal. I can't believe it. It's surreal. It's incredible.
You know the history, Tony, as well as anyone. How have they done this?
Hard work. Just never gave up. You know, big hearts. They're just incredible.
Tom, your experience, I mean, you were so low-key in the build-up.
Yeah.
Were you on the inside quite nervous?
Nah, not at all. Just plenty of these and off I go.
Who's more excited, you or your dad, do you reckon?
Oh, I've got no idea. He'll probably lap up the fame time this week, do a few cashies and roll it in, won't you?
Tony, put it into context for us. You know, you were at the Dogs when they were on their knees. Now they're flying higher than anyone else.
It's beautiful. You know, it's incredible. It's history in the making, and these guys are going to create their own dynasty.
Who's behind it in your view? Who was the key change?
Look, you know, Luke Beveridge, obviously. He's the man. He's the head man. So he's the one who's got them going, and incredible.
We're going to get pissed tonight.
Yeah, you'll be pissed on 3 beers.
And Tom, tell us the significance of getting Bob Murphy. Were you ever going to let him stay on the ground, or did you need to get him up on the dais like you did?
No, I mean, he's the most inspirational leader that I've ever come across, and the way he's moulded himself, regardless of if he's playing or not, with the players, and how he still influences us regardless of where he is incredible. So he deserves every minute of it.
Well, it's historic just standing next to two Liberatore's on this monumental day. Raise a glass, 3 cheers.
Yeah! Well done, Sam. That's terrific to see, isn't it? We know Tony Liberatore, part of the heart and soul of the club.
Absolutely. And the fact that he has Tom over for dinner still every night before a home game. I mean, obviously, we saw him yesterday down at Fed Square, Tony Liberatore, and he said the scenes at Witten Oval during the week, there was more people at the ground than what he used to play in front of. And we're actually just seeing Jordan Ruffin out here just soaking it up. He's just walking around the ground. He's been just walking around with his partner, just walking around soaking it up. This is great times.
So these are live pictures, and Jordan, we might even get him over. I wonder if he might just pop over and say good day. So walking around in his shorts and his jumper, and he's got his premiership medal on, and Jordan, come on in, mate.
Fantastic, mate. Congratulations.
Thank you. We're just commenting on this must be the most special feeling right now. You just walking around the ground and looking around and taking it all in.
It's pretty amazing. Today, I don't know. I can't put today into words. I'm a lifelong Doggies fan. So 25 years, I've hoped the boys would win a flag, and to actually be out there and be involved is quite unbelievable. And I'm sure it'll sink in over the next few days and weeks, but yeah, it's pretty cool.
Tell us what that moment was like down in the rooms. We could just see the scenes on just when Bebo's talking, and all the boys are erupting, and the cup is sitting down in front of you there.
I don't know. Sorry, I'm just all. I don't know what to say. I mean, it's but the thing about that win is it's not just the 22 players that were out there. We've got 45 on the list that they've all contributed, whether it's by playing games, whether it's just by being there and helping us along the way. And the coaching staff, the admin staff, the whole footy club. This is for the whole footy club. It's the supporters, it's the members, it's everyone who's waited those 62 years to watch the Doggies win a cup.
Hey, Jordan, can I ask, did you know that Luke was considering giving his premiership medal to Bob?
No, I had no idea. What I can guarantee is that there'd be 22 blokes that'd be more than happy to give Murph their premiership medal. He's more important to us than any win, than any premiership, than any medal ever could be. He's a phenomenal man, and the way he's kept us together this year, we could have easily sort of fallen apart with the injuries, and him being one of them was big enough. But He's an incredible man, and I can guarantee you that this wouldn't have happened if he wasn't around the footy club.
How special is, Luke Beveridge and what he's brought to this club? This is a dynasty and a young side that is just creating history, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's funny, I mean, we've talked a lot about belief across the last month, and internally we have all year. It's just kind of hit the media in the last month, and the belief he's got in us as players and our whole coaching staff have in us as players is you can't help but play good footy under him. And that's been the case when he was coaching Amos, when he was coaching at the Hawks and Collingwood, and now we're so lucky to have him involved at our footy club. And for him to win the Coach of the Year award and then a few days later go on and win a flag is pretty special.
Hey, so. Jordan, congratulations. Is that your girlfriend over there?
Bridge, yeah.
Yeah, she's been patiently waiting and... mate, congratulations.
Good on you, mate.
Continue to soak it up, mate.
I'll let you get back in there because you've got to get back out here.
Yeah, good on you guys. Thank you.
Well done. So Jordan Ruffhead, one of the stars of today. And for the girlfriend, off they go. Just beautiful. Viewers in Perth, if you'd like to continue watching the Virgin Australia Premiership Party, switch across now to 7, mate. And it's going to be a big party for the Western Bulldogs, that's for sure. Let's have a look at the best moments of this beautiful day for the Western Bulldogs. Premiers again after 62 years. Just give me, something to believe in. Every day when I speak to the moon, pale as a ghost in the afternoon. Tragedy has a hold on my mind, but I can see the light between the lights. I say, you've got to listen. I'm a songbird with a brand new... So Bob Murphy, and the man we just spoke to just a few moments ago, Jordan Ruffhead, and now Easton Woody's out on the ground, and he's got a few people with him, so just the special moments
Rowan
continue.
Smith's with him there walking around. It's this is just wonderful to see. They're actually taking the moment to just really soak it up.
Let's get back to Danny McGinley. The Living End about to continue the Virgin Australia Premiership Party. What a party it is for these Bulldogs.
That's so good. What else? They've got over 7, Albert, 25 ARIA Award nominations. It's so good. They're releasing their 7th album, Shift, earlier this year. They're fresh from a sold-out tour of the US. It's going to be amazing. And then after that, ladies and gentlemen, the 2016 AFL Premiership team. They're coming up, Living End, very soon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Toyota AFL Grand Final Day, and this is the Virgin Australia Premiership Party.
Thank you.
Like a drink, right? If anyone's got a VB, don't hold back. Send it forward. Pay a handsome reward.
Center of
lights out. Right here in Melbourne town. That defines you. Black wing falls in the promised land. Black wing falls in the promised land. Keep your distance, stay in the shadow. No promise there'll be tomorrow. Stop what you have, what you choose. That defines you. How's everyone feeling? All right? I'm feeling good. Back in the hometown. Our parents were both born in Footscray, so this is a very special day. Without further ado, we'll be right back. out. We haven't got time to fool around, man. We're here for one thing. Let's play rock and roll, ladies and gentlemen. If I don't see all you guys moving, I'm coming out there. I mean it.
Last one.
The Living End with their tribute to the Western Bulldogs. The Premiers, the Virgin Australia Premiership Party continues. When we come back, we'll bring the Bulldogs out live on stage with their fans. Don't go away.
Gentlemen, allow me to bring to the stage the 2016 Premiers. In order, ladies and gentlemen, Marcus Bontempelli. Matthew Boyd, Luke Dalhouse, Lockie Hunter, Jake Stringer's coming out, there's Jack McRae, Zane Cordy, Clay Smith, Toby McLean, Tom Boyd, Fletcher Roberts, Josh Dunkley, Tom Liberatore, Jordan Ruffett, Shane Biggs, Tory Dixon, Joel Hamling, Caleb Daniel, Dale Morris, Jason Johansson, Liam Picken, and ladies and gentlemen, our captain for today, Easton Woods, and our true spiritual leader, Bob Murphy. And the dog father, ladies and gentlemen, Luke Beveridge.
You did it.
This is what you've worked for, lads. Enjoy this. What you guys have achieved today means so much to every single person in this stadium. I don't know, there's so many I want to speak to. Bont, you were immense. How's the feeling been in the rooms? Is there words?
It's hard to describe. What we've achieved today is something that I know all of us will look back on for a long time to come, and it's great to see so many people here who've helped us achieve it, so thank you.
It's so good. Where's JJ? Your Norm Smith medalist, ladies and gentlemen, Jason Johansson. They look good on you.
Couple of bling.
What was your favourite part of the match?
When the siren went in the fourth quarter. Yeah.
Oh my God, I like that bit too.
No, it was amazing.
Well, you guys have been so awesome, but I got to bring on the star of the show. I mean, you're all stars, so it's just, ladies and gentlemen, Premiership coach Luke Beveridge. And ladies and gentlemen, we got him. Is he there? Ladies and gentlemen, well, where's Easton's up already? We got Easton. We got Bob. Bob's here. How good are you, Bob? Bevo, like, what do you say to Bevo? What do you say to a premiership-winning team in the rooms? Do you even say anything, or is it all just shouted?
Oh no, we didn't have any words because. There's too much emotion, but obviously over the course of the next week or so, we'll reflect and point the spotlight of what an amazing achievement our players have pulled off. It's an incredible night. It's an amazing day. We said this afternoon, you know, the game went really quick. There wasn't enough time to win it, but it seemed like there was enough time to lose it. So it's all we can do is just pay kudos and homage to this 22 out on the stage and their teammates who didn't take the field today. Amazing effort.
Let's talk to our co-captains, ladies and gentlemen. Bob, is this everything you'd imagined?
We must be dreaming. It's incredible. It means more to all of us than any of us could put into words, but we are taking over the world tonight.
Yes. And Easton, what was your favourite part of the game? At what point did you relax and think we've won? Is it now?
when that siren went, mate, unbelievable. And then the roar and the noise and the emotion and the elation that you see on your teammates' faces, unbelievable.
It really is surreal. Who's hogged the cup the most?
Clay.
Boyd. Everyone saying Boyd.
No way.
There are so many champions up here on the stage. I want to ask Matty Boyd, you've had a lot of Mad Mondays. How good's this one going to be?
Mad?
It's going to be real mad. Don't worry about that. Oh, yeah.
Get it up?
I think we should get it up, ladies and gentlemen. Should we get it up? Lads, we saw you sing the song in the rooms. It's going to be a really special moment when that happens. Oh, they're getting in. They're getting ready.
You got to let him start it.
All right, Lukey Dias is the man for this. That was absolutely perfect. We just on behalf of every Footscray fan, every Western Bulldogs diehard, thank you so much for winning.
Suck it up, guys. This is real. It's actually happened. Enjoy. Unbelievable.
So where's the party tonight? Where do we go?
To the moon.
Don't tell her. I don't even know. I don't. Well, just come back to my place, ladies and gentlemen. That's fine. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the 2016 AFL Premiers, the Western Bulldogs!
Western Bulldogs to be enjoying what's happening out on the stage now. And Jude, even Sydney supporters on this dark day for them, I'm sure will admire greatly what they've seen from this group.
Absolutely. The fact that they've broken a premiership drought, this is just such a special moment to be involved in. And I think, you all pinch yourself just the fact that you've seen, witnessed something really special on the MCG.
They've carried themselves with great dignity and led so well by their club captain and, of course, their coach, Luke Beveridge. Just fantastic. And well done to Danny McGinley, who was the MC on the stage. Danny, of course, is the comedian who writes their banners for them each week and has done a terrific job and kept the footy world entertained with his words of wisdom.
He was pretty excited. I think you can see how much of a die-hard Doggies fan he is.
So it's a song that is going to continue to be played over the next few days, that's for sure. Well done to the Western Bulldogs. Our congratulations to them. We'd like to show you now in the rooms after the game when the Bulldogs went back inside. They then sung the song. We saw the first rendition, but then all of the officials and the players back into the coach's room for a very special version of the Bulldogs song. Let's have a look.
I think it's important that we all maybe sing the club song again.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Let's put the cup in there.
Special, isn't it? And our thanks to the Western Bulldogs. That was club footage which they released and made available to us, and terrific for their fans to get to see that. Jude, you've done that. You know how special that must be.
It is. You just soak that up, and as we got a chance to speak to Jordan Ruffhead, and he was just soaking up the moment every bit. You just want to remember this as a group, and the collective there in there celebrating, they've done something really special today.
It's been a historic day. The Bulldogs are premiers, and the football talk continues tomorrow. Game day on Channel 7, our grand final show, the lucky last for the year, hosted by Hamish, of course, Lee Matthews, Andrew Welsh, and Jude, you'll be there alongside Matty Boyd. That's going to be pretty special.
And Matty Boyd was obviously terrific today at 27 disposals. He was one of those halfbacks that really dominated with Johannesson and cut the Swans up.
And there's a lot of sport still coming your way on Channel 7. On 7-2 tomorrow from 11:30 Australian Eastern, Yellow Glen Turnbull Stakes Day. So there is something for everyone. It's been a wonderful day, maybe not for the Sydney Swans, Jude. Commiserations for all Sydney supporters. But for the Western Bulldogs, the 62-year wait is over. And on the day when the great Dennis Cometti called his final game for Channel 7, the Bulldogs are the premiers of the AFL for 2016. On behalf of all of the team, thanks for being a part of Grand Final Day, and we can't wait to do it all over again next year. On behalf of all of us, good night.